We have weather data from 4 sites: Arizona, Oklahoma, Texas, and Kansas. Near each of these 4 sites, there was a weather station. Weather stations can gather data about weather conditions, like wind speed, humidity, and size of the storm. Start by making this summary table on your piece of paper. Next, copy down the information from the hailstorm that I analyzed from Oklahoma. The temperature was 77 degrees and decreased. The humidity was 79% and increased. The wind speed was increasing. There were gusts that were increasing after the storm. The size of the storm was 60 miles. The shape was 2 lines. The time of the day was evening, and the time of year was spring. Now we're going to analyze the weather conditions from a hailstorm in Texas together. The location is Dallas, Texas. The date, June 13th, 2013. Approximate time of day of the storm, 7:30 p.m. And the size of the storm was about 10 miles and about 20 miles. I'm going to double click on the map to see it larger. I can see that here and here is where the hailstorm happened. And I can also see that this color right here means that the hail was about 1.75 inches wide, and that this hail over here was about 1 inch wide. I can see that both of these storms were pretty small because they were happening in one city. I'm going to go back to my data set. My data set shows the time of day where the data was taken, the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, relative humidity in percentage, wind speed, the average speed of the wind over the hour, and wind gusts, if there was any sudden and fast gusts of wind. I'm interested in the time of the day where the storm happened, which was 7:30 p.m. So I'm going to look for that on my data set. And oh no, I don't see 7:30 p.m. I've got 2 choices. I could look at the data right before the storm happened, or the data during the storm. What would you choose? I chose the data from 7:52 because this will tell me more about what it was like during the storm. I'm going to highlight that row of information. You can go to your paint bucket to change it to a different color, or you can highlight it and change the color. The first piece of information we're looking for is temperature. Write down, what was the temperature during the hailstorm? Was the temperature increasing or decreasing before the hailstorm? You should have written 66 degrees Fahrenheit and decreasing. Next, we need to look at humidity. What was the humidity during the storm? Was the humidity increasing or decreasing before the storm? You should have written 75% and increasing. Next, wind speed. For this one, let's just write if it was increasing or decreasing. You should have written the wind speed was increasing. Next, wind gusts. What do you notice about the wind gusts after the storm? You should have written increasing. This is a crazy pattern. It was 0 miles per hour all day, and then there were some really big gusts after the storm. Next, the size of the storm. What was the size of the storm? The smaller storm was 10 miles long. And the larger storm was 20 miles long. Next, shape. Does the shape look like lines or circles to you? I noticed it looked like 1, 2, 3 lines. Next, time of day. The storm happened at 7:30 p.m. Did the storm happen in the morning, afternoon, or evening? You should have written evening. Last, time of year. Did the storm happen in the summer, fall, winter, or spring? You should have written summer. Now that we've analyzed the data from one hailstorm together, it's your turn to analyze data on your own. You have 2 choices. You can analyze data from the Kansas hailstorm by clicking here and having more help from a teacher. Or, if you feel like you have the hang of it, skip this page and analyze data from the Arizona hailstorm on your own without any help from a teacher.